Hello, and welcome to How to Record a Webinar Using a Mac for Free. My name is Kate Mosley, and I'm an AT specialist. I am a task employee that contracts with STAR to provide AT webinars and trainings. You can view these trainings at www.startraining.org. This PowerPoint will be available for your own use. If you have any additional questions or have an idea of a webinar you'd like me to do, please email me at tasc@ucphuntsville.org. So just a little bit about TASC and STAR. TASC stands for Technology Assistance for Special Consumers. We do AT consultations, informal sessions, and technical assistance. We also have a lending library where you can check out any of our equipment for 2 to 3 weeks. This equipment includes switches, mounts, adaptive toys, communication aids, aids to daily living, and computer keyboard adaptions. STAR is Alabama's assistive technology resource. Their website, AT for All, is an online database that provides current inventory of AT and medical equipment. You may also post want ads for items you do not find listed. These items may include wheelchairs, scooters, shower bath aids, bedside commodes, and more. You can also view the TASC lending library from this website. In this webinar, we will be going over what is needed to do a computer recording, how to use QuickTime, how to use iMovie, how to upload your video to YouTube, how to create subtitles on YouTube, and how to record your iPad, iPhone, or iPod on your computer. So what you will need. For computer recordings, all you will need is QuickTime and iMovie. You will also need iOS, but all of these programs are already pre-installed into your MacBook. iOS is the operating system for Apple, so if you bought your MacBook at a local Apple retailer, it comes with all of these programs already. For iPad recordings, you will need QuickTime, iMovie, and iOS, but you will also need a Lightning to USB cord, like the one seen here, or this cord. Whichever cord came with your iPad that you used to charge your iPad with is the cord you will use. You will also need an iPad. So let's start for how to record your computer screen. So before we get into the demonstration, I would like to go over a few things that you might not be able to see on my screen because I am recording with this program, so I won't be able to show you these features. When you first open QuickTime, you will have a box appear on your screen similar to this one. I usually ignore this box and go straight into File, and then under the File folder, you will see a button that says Start Screen Recording. Go ahead and click on that, and you will have a box like this pop up on your screen. This is the recording headquarters. Push the red dot to start your screen recording, and then a bar will appear on your screen that says you have started your recording. Below, if you click on this little arrow here, it will give you a drop-down box where you can choose which microphone you would like to record your audio and options such as showing your mouse clicks in your recordings. Once you are done with your recording, push the stop button that'll appear on this upper bar, and you are ready to save your recording. So to start screen recording on your Mac, you're going to want to open QuickTime. I have QuickTime open on my dock over here. If you take 3 fingers and a thumb on your trackpad and pull them close into each other, you can be open up into the applications menu, and QuickTime would be there. If you don't like that motion, you can always go into Finder and then Applications and scroll down until you see QuickTime. So my QuickTime is already open because I am recording, but once you open QuickTime, you will have a bar up at the top of your computer. From here, click File and then all the way down to New Screen Recording. I'm unable to click mine because I am currently recording my screen. From there, a small recording box will pop up, and once you push the record button, you will be able to record everything that happens on your desktop. You can also record video, I'm sorry, audio along with your video recording. Once you are done with your video recording, go back up to your top bar and click on this stop button right here. Once you have finished recording your clip, the clip will zoom up on a screen that I have outlined in red. Here you can watch the clip you just recorded, and if you are satisfied with it, press the red X at the top left corner. Once you click the red X, this small box will appear on your screen and ask if you would like to save your clip that you just recorded. If you are unhappy and would like to re-record, click Don't Save. If you are happy with your recording, you can name your recording under the Export As bar and then save where you would like your recording to be. So once you have recorded your movie, save it to your computer. I like to save it to my desktop for easy access. Now let's open iMovie. Again, iMovie is in my dock, but you can always go into Finder, Applications, and then go to iMovie. So once iMovie pops up, it'll look something like this. To the left, you will have iMovie's library. Here you will have events. These events are similar to a photo album. To make a new movie, you will go to New, and then Movie. You can use different themes for your movies, including all the ones shown here. I like to go with Simple for my presentations. Then you push Create down at the bottom right-hand corner. Now you can name your movie. And add it to an event. You can add an event by either right-clicking iMovie Library and then tapping New Event, or going into File and making a new event. Again, an event is just similar to an album for photos. So from here, you have your movie. What you will need to do is import your video. So this is very similar to your Finder bar. I like to go to desktop, and then I'm going to click on my screen recording. Once I've clicked on it, just push Import Selected, and your video will appear at the bottom of your list. To add your recorded video to your iMovie video, simply highlight and then click and drag. Now, my previous screen recording is in my movie. You can add multiple screen recordings by importing them and then just simply dragging them to your iMovie part. So after you have imported and placed the clips you want to use into your movie, you are ready to edit your movie. You can trim your clips by either clicking on a section and dragging the length of what you want to delete. From here, you can either shorten or extend it to exactly what you want to delete. Then right-clicking, and you're given your options. You can also click the entire clip, and when you see an arrow, drag your clip to the desired length. If you'd like to move your clip, simply click on the entire clip and drag it. You can also work with contrast, colors, cutting the screen of your clip, and even working with volume. Once you have edited your movie to exactly how you'd like it to be, click on your recording and then click Share. You can share this video either through email, iTunes, Facebook, or YouTube, or you can click on File. From File, you can edit the format, the resolution, and the quality. I will save this to my desktop as New Example Movie. although you can change where you'd like it to save. And then up in this corner, you're going to have a ring. This ring is a timer of how long it will take to create your video. You can see that my new example movie is on my desktop, but it will not be able to open until this little circle is completely white. So you can see it's starting to go there. Once your file has been completely downloaded, let's review how to upload your video onto YouTube and how to add subtitles to that YouTube video. So back in iMovie, we have our share button. If you just want to directly upload your video into the format YouTube requires, click on YouTube. Again, you will go through the naming process and your video should appear on your YouTube channel. You will need to log in to YouTube and have a YouTube account to post to YouTube. So this is the task YouTube page. I'm going to go ahead and go to my channel. Here's where all the task videos are listed. So to edit one of my videos, I'm going to click on the video, then hit Video Manager. It's going to bring us to our video page where I can edit any of the videos I've posted at any time. So I'm going to click on Edit. Here I am brought to the video's settings. By clicking Subtitles and Closed Captioning, I will be brought to this page. Now, YouTube has a feature that it will try to translate everything you're saying into subtitles. It is under English Automatic. Now, as you can see from the first few subtitle captions, it is not very accurate. So what you will need to do is go down to the bottom and click Edit. From here, I can change what the subtitle is saying, and I can even change what time it appears on the screen. So if this exact caption only needs to be until the 0.4 second mark, then I can do that. I can also play and type while I hear my video. Once I'm done, I can push Publish Edits. I haven't edited these, so I'm not going to go ahead and do that. But once you push Publish Edits, the subtitles will appear on your YouTube video when closed captioning is tapped onto your computer. So as mentioned before, you will need an iPad and the type of cable you would use to charge it. What you're going to do is plug your cable into your iPad and then plug the USB portion into the computer, similar to how you would hook up your iPad to iTunes. So once you have your iPad hooked up to your computer through its connection cable, you are going to want to open QuickTime and go under File, New Movie Recording. So you can see that my iPad is up on the screen. Now if I touch my iPad by swiping, you can see that it follows it. I can even go into Apps and play on the apps and it'll appear on the screen. Now, what may happen is that your desktop camera may come up. If that is the case, right next to the record button is a little arrow. Click on that arrow to either move between the FaceTime HD camera, which is the camera that's built into your computer, or the iPad. Once you are ready to record, go ahead and push the record button, and now everything that I do on the iPad will appear in my recording. Once done, end recording, exit out, and you can save your clip as anything to wherever you need to send it. Just a reminder that what I just demonstrated works with iPads, iPhones, and iPods. All three of those devices will appear up on your MacBook screen. When you have finished your clip and would like to process it in iMovie, go through the same steps that I demonstrated with the screen recording previously in this webinar. Now for a bit more information. Here are some resources. If you would like for more information about iMovie, please visit apple.com/mac/iMovie. Here you can learn to utilize all the features this program has to offer, including light balance and audio quality. If you are interested in more information about QuickTime, please visit apple.com/quicktime/download to download the current version of QuickTime. If you have any questions, please email me at tasc@ucphuntsville.org. If you are an AT specialist, therapist, educator, vendor, or a user, and you are interested in creating your own webinar, please email me. After a review, your webinar may be posted to our STAR Training website. If you have an idea or figured out an alternative way to use technology, we would like to know. If you had difficulty learning to do something, there is probably someone who would like to know how you completed your task. If you would like to share some technology that you use in your everyday life, please let us know. Last but not least, if you found a solution to a difficult problem, we would like to hear how you solved your problem. You now have all the knowledge to teach others about your finds in the AT world. Just a reminder that practice makes perfect. iMovie is great because you can edit small parts of your clip and add in revisions as needed. Thank you very much for attending this webinar.